While my 600-pound life has featured some dramatic transformations and has changed many lives for the better, some contestants haven't fared as well or even come out alive. Over the course of the show's 9 seasons, a number of cast members have sadly died. The season 1 fan favorite Henry Foots of My 600-Pound Life had a pretty successful experience on the show, dropping from nearly 750 pounds all the way down to about 275, according to Starcasm. The Texas native was aiming to lose weight for his high school reunion and did a commendable job.
To some people, I'm still considered obese. But they don't know I'm on the downside to being normal.
As a result of the weight loss, Henry underwent skin removal surgery to shed some of his leftover skin. During the second surgery, his heart stopped on the operating table, with Henry telling TLC, "There was the light to take me to heaven, but I wasn't ready for it." In 2012, Henry was behind the wheel of a shuttle bus when he lost control, sadly killing a woman standing on the street in the process. Rumors spread on the internet that Henry died in the crash, but that wasn't the case. He lived for another year before dying in May of 2013. His cause of death hasn't been made public. Cameron Park, California's Sean Milliken was one of the biggest stars ever on My 600-Pound Life, tipping the scales at over 900 pounds at his heaviest, according to the Daily Mail. Sean sought help because he knew he wouldn't live to see 30 at his current weight, and he couldn't stand up for more than half a minute. According to People, the star left bed for the first time in years to travel to Houston, seeking potentially life-saving surgery with Dr. Now. Sean's confinement to bed stemmed from a leg injury he suffered during high school, but his overeating began because of his strained relationship with his father, who was actually the one to break the news of Sean's death to the world via a Facebook post, according to the Daily Mail. He said his son had died due to complications from an infection, adding that his son had been a good man with a good heart. When James King appeared on My 600-Pound Life during Season 5, he was the heaviest cast member in history at an astonishing 791 pounds, according to The Sun. By the time the program's My 600-Pound Life Where Are They Now spinoff aired, he'd shot up to 840 pounds. James got so heavy that Dr. Now even called Adult Protective Services on James' wife, assuming she was illicitly feeding her husband while he was in the hospital trying to lose weight ahead of surgery. James was summarily let go from Dr. Now's program. James was never in fantastic health, ending up in intensive care in 2017 for cirrhosis, kidney failure, and sepsis. According to The Sun, this led to premature rumors of his death. By 2020, James' health had worsened, and after an extended stay in the hospital, he ultimately died of kidney failure. One source told The Sun that James died weighing about 500 pounds. An unnamed insider told the tabloid he would have been proud of himself. James' funeral was kept private, as his death occurred during the height of the coronavirus pandemic. New Jersey native Robert Buchel became the first person to die while filming his episode of My 600-Pound Life. He passed away from a heart attack on November 15, 2017. He joined Dr. Now's program in hopes of losing weight ahead of his upcoming wedding and made pretty good progress at first. Robert's weight peaked at 842 pounds, but he shed 124 pounds during his first month on the program. He then lost another 98 pounds at rehab center and another 78 after that. However, Robert had to have a surgery to remove a lymphedema mass, which made losing weight much harder. After the surgery, things got dark for Robert. Though he'd lost 340 pounds and was down to a manageable 502, Robert had also developed an addiction to pain medication. The addiction was so strong at one point, Starcasm reported, that he tore some of his surgical stitches trying to get more painkillers. Robert went back to rehab, but wouldn't exercise at all without pain medication. Ultimately, he suffered a heart attack and died. Dr. Now commented in memoriam, "Robert battled an addiction and lost, but he never gave up." While some of the stars of My 600-Pound Life sadly died due to health complications brought on by their weight, James L.B. Bonner's story is far darker. He had a relatively successful experience on My 600-Pound Life, going from 642 pounds at the show's beginning to a noteworthy 324 pounds, according to TMZ, and his weight loss continued even after the camera stopped rolling. But losing weight didn't quiet whatever demons haunted him, and in the summer of 2018, he penned a foreboding Facebook post, saying, "I just want to say thank you to everyone who has shown me love and support throughout my journey. I've realized a few things over the last few days, and it's time that I face my demons head-on." Later that week, LB was found dead in a park in his hometown of Lexington, South Carolina, the victim of a gunshot wound to the head. Shortly after, local police ruled the death a suicide. He was only 30 years old. If you or anyone you know is having suicidal thoughts, please call the National Suicide Prevention Lifeline at 1-800-273-TALK. That's 1-800-273-8255. Lisa Fleming was one of the more shocking cast members to ever appear on My 600-Pound Life. The Alabama native revealed during the show that she turned to eating as a child to deal with her parents' divorce. She later developed an even unhealthier relationship with food when her mother used eating to punish her. According to the Cinemaholic, one particularly disturbing incident involved Lisa's mother forcing her to eat an entire cake by herself after she'd tasted some without permission. Lisa also told a story of finding maggots in the folds of her skin after she topped out at over 700 pounds. That stomach-turning event led her to seek help, which she found with Dr. Now and My 600-Pound Life. While on the program, Lisa was confined to bed, needing 7 paramedics to get her out.
"This is not the life that I want to live."
Although Lisa's daughter told TMZ that she had been ill before the show, Lisa managed to lose 200 pounds after filming wrapped. Still, Lisa's poor health ultimately got the better of her, and in late August 2018, she passed away. One of the most heartbreaking patients ever to appear on My 600-Pound Life was Kelly Mason. The North Carolinian came to Dr. Now weighing over 700 pounds, suffering from diabetes, high blood pressure, arthritis, thyroid issues, a pulmonary embolism, and a blood clot in her leg. Oh, and she'd also just been in the hospital for congestive heart failure, according to Distractify. As Dr. Now so bluntly put it, "Every day is a question of whether you'll survive or not." But Kelly worked hard. After Dr. Now sent her to a hospital, she dropped 100 pounds. She lost another 220 while prepping for weight loss surgery, and ultimately lost 324 pounds while awaiting surgery. When leaving the hospital, she said, "It feels like the first day of a new life, actually." Unfortunately, in one of the saddest moments in the show's history, audiences saw Dr. Now take a call from the Houston coroner telling him Kelly died of cardiac arrest in her sleep. She was the second cast member to pass away during filming. The most recent cast member of My 600-Pound Life to pass away was Kalisa McMillan, a Season 8 star who dropped 150 pounds during her time on the show, according to the Cinemaholic. While an impressive feat, Dr. Now still didn't feel Kalisa had lost enough weight to qualify for weight loss surgery. Kalisa complained of chronic stomach pain, and Dr. Now feared she might have a fatal blockage in her intestines. Kalisa's weight made it impossible to determine what was causing the pain, so Dr. Now did the weight loss surgery despite his concerns. Soon after the surgery, Kalisa began experiencing more issues. According to Starcasm, Kalisa's niece reported that a suture from her aunt's gastric sleeve popped, causing severe sepsis. Kalisa was put on a ventilator for 2.5 weeks, then put into a medically induced coma and placed on life support. Though she survived, it wasn't for long, as she ultimately died in September of 2020.